Welcome to Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan. I'm about to play some standard with my Esper control deck. I am 2-0 with the deck so far, but I still don't really know what I'm doing. I think Sphinx's Revelation should be banned now. It seems like an extremely powerful card. I remember when they restricted Braingazer and Sphinx's Revelations just a lot stronger. Gnarly Grande is my opponent. Would you like to play first? Yes, I would like to play first. 26 land. There is one of them. Alright, this is what I'm keeping. What can I do with Azorius Charm? I can get lifelink, I can draw a card, or put attacking or blocking creature. So I guess I should play... yeah, you know what I mean. Shockland first. Oh, Selesnya! So, do I now draw a card? I wonder. Is that what I do? Oh, it's Domri Raid! I never played against him before. I think I'm drawing that card. And playing the Isolated Chapel. Detaining Domri, right? Ah, Domri, you're under arrest. Killed by missing mortars. There is the Cavern of Souls, which means that I can't counter elementals. Such as that guy. Okay, so I can't cast any spells on his turn. Which is bad for my counter spell, so I will need to angel him. I can see where this is going. It doesn't have someone big enough to fight, but soon he will get the emblem. And then I'm just gone. And he will get the emblems long before I... long before I get the angel. Do I rather want him to have that? Maybe I do, actually. Overcasting Syncopate. How weak is that? So you got a 3-3 instead of a 4-4, that must be good. It's just someone else I can kill with the angel. Oh, Loxodon's Mighty can't be countered. That was a small parenthesis. I was too obsessed with looking at the elemental ability that I didn't notice that Loxodon Smiter can't be countered. I think counter spells are pretty bad in this matchup. And I won't even have time to get to the angel. And even if I do, he will ultimate Domri right after that. So let's get rid of the counter spells. And bring in what? Okay. And that's why we don't like playing in the practice room. Maybe he thought I was too noobish. And didn't want to play me. I don't know. But I'll play another match. That means I simply don't count that, but I wanted to play the whole match because I think he had an excellent matchup against me. And it was nice to see Domri in action because I haven't seen him before. And he looked quite powerful. Waiting for a new opponent. Sorry about random people quitting on me. I have set up this buddy system, or not this buddy system, but the buddy system on Magic Gathering Strat account to enable me to find reliable sparring partners for Pauper, but I don't know how to set it up for another format as well. Now it's very easy to overlook for Pauper. To see us online, know that these are all people that want to play Pauper. But I don't know what to do about Standard and Modern. And I will definitely look to get into Modern a lot. When Modern Masters hits, or 3 months after Modern Masters hits, when prices are low. They are running an early system scheduled downtime today, which really sucks because I have time off to play today and today only. I think this is a mulligan, right? And I'm gonna keep that. And I won't be able to play anything for quite some time. And then of course I can just not draw land, and next turn I can play Syncopate at least. But given the pace he develops, I think he too is playing a control deck, in which case I need to go the aggressive route and play the Precinct Captain. Because he's my anti-control card. God, I want to play Jace! Okay, I'm going to counter everything. He will cast Supreme Verdict and I won't be able to counter that. There's a lot of things in Standard right now that can't be countered. Yay. Okay, I'm drawing a card here. So he will be casting really nasty stuff soon. I want to pay the 2 life, play the Jace. And I'm gonna immediately factor fiction this time, right? But he should be counted. And he's counted. His goal must be to cast angels here. And I am playing Obsidat. They get counted too. Well, I can swing this revelation for two at the end of his turn. While he casts Think Twice. Well, he gets two cards, I get two cards. I think it's fair. Godless Shrine. Am I going to waste the Blood Baron? Not really. I'll just sit around here, do nothing, and wait for my revelations to gain me superiority. As his Think Twice is doing. No way, sir. Oh, it's a do nothing enchantment. Well, I know how to handle that. So, you cannot have that. He doesn't have too many creatures, I think. So, random Sky Knight! Getting impatient. Giant Revelation next turn. But so will he. And I cannot counter his. How big is mine? Mine is 5 and his is 6. Well, I think it's revelation time. His is 7. Well, I might as well cast mine now, because I won't be allowed to do that later. Discard Godless Shrine. Okay, so he has plenty of cards. And I don't think I have plenty. He is red, white, blue. Okay. So he has counter spells for everything. I randomly try to sneak through a Jace here. But my verdicts don't feel very good against him. That guy, why isn't everybody playing Snapcaster Mage? He must be so good. Why is Snapcaster Mage not fantastic? Especially in a deck with Sphinx's Revelation. He looks pretty good to me. So now my final threat is the Blood Baron, but he will not make it. I should draw a card with... the Sorcery Charm. Blood Baron of Iskopa. Protection from white, but... will that really help him? Lifelink, draw a card. No, doesn't matter. Missing Mortars is quality removal. I'm being out-controlled here. Do I really have to detention swear the Snapcaster Mage? Oh my god, I'll supreme verdict him. I think Jay's Memory Adept would do some work here. Oh, Snapcaster for Sphinx's Revelation. That means 8 Sphinx's Revelation instead of 4 like me. I think people are underestimating Sphinx's Revelation. Underestimating Snapcaster Mage. A card that made regrowth unrestricted in Classic because it was so much better than regrowth. That's not to be ignored. Now he has all the counter spells in the world. Wow, this guy really has a lot more card draw than I have. Wow, he even has to cast the cards in my face. 10. Is there X damage spells? I feel that this will probably not work, will it? This is really irritating with the shocklands, that you have to choose for each shockland. I want to cast a Sphinx's Revelation for 8. Can I do that, please? Probably not. Oh, nasty. Can I have Jace? I really want to have a Jace. If I can't have a Jace, you can't have a Snapcaster Mage. I can have a Jace. Let's look for stuff. Well, it's pretty much Jace, isn't it? Okay. And then I verdict. sticking a jace to the board. Why am I not? He must have too few finishers, right? So I'm plussing my jace, drawing a card at the end of his turn, probably. So am I now going to deck him? Is that the plan? I think it pretty much is the plan. Okay, let's try to ultimate Jace. That sounds like super fun. Play threat. Oh my god. He's gonna burn me out. And he's going to do quite well at it. So maybe I have to use the Jace to actually find something to help me. I'm still 6 cards ahead of him. Can Sphinx's Revelation work on the opponent? I don't think so. Uh-oh. I don't have anything to help me. No, it burned me out. Pretty sweet. Okay, I feel my supreme verdicts weren't very good here. Definitely Blood Baron. Rest in peace. That's a overkill, right? For 4 snapcast mages. What do you do? Oh, you have protection from red. That must be pretty useful. So maybe it's not the Blood Baron. Maybe it's something like this. But anti-counter stuff should be good, of course. So that leaves the Blood Baron out. Like that. Okay. For some more control versus control action. Stay tuned. 6 lands. I'm gonna keep that. I think it's actually good to be sure to make your land drops in a matchup like this. So, play the shock lands first. Yeah, just keep playing shocklands. This spell should be really good in this matchup. He doesn't miss a beat. But nor do I. Okay, Lavinia. Protection red 4/4. That's awesome. So I can cast her when I reach 6 mana, and once she sticks, she will get Supreme Verdicted, but at least she's immune to all the damage spells. D Do we cast her? I think we do. But he could have double counter, but that's pretty specific. And now he has missed land drops as well. So I am playing her. As a 4-4 Dirdle with protection red, but I think that is exactly what he needs in his head. I hope that was what she was there for. Supreme verdict. Oh, what the hell? Oh my god. The Moon Sage! Can I detentions with her? Well, I can. The detentions with her is pretty good. Do I now play a Sky Knight too? Why not? Why not, I say? Tap out control. Supreme verdict. Yes. So that's why not. Just in case you were wondering. Okay, as predicted, nobody got an advantage at the early start, so now it's all about the Sphinx's revelations. And I look for a dispel. That is not a dispel. And his Sphinx's revelation resolves. Which is really bad news. Well, have to do some things. I'm deploying a threat here. Who there is a thousand ways to kill, but at least he will be the one who dies and not I. Another revelation. No, it's Aetherling. It's unblockable. Wow. I really get the flashback from the Morphling days. Oh, he didn't exile it. So now a unique chance of killing it, except that he has a grip full of counter spells. Yeah. His experience playing control decks shows here, while my inexperience. Could my dramatic rescue target his detention spheres? Probably not. He's now out of it, but I can target his detention sphere, right? But that means that Tamiyo comes into play, and I don't want that. I want Tamiyo gone. So now I'll start to take Etherling beats. And I think, I hope this is just a horrible matchup for me, as I am more creature centric than he is. So the slightly slower deck often wins. But that I have a better matchup against the aggro decks than he does. But I'm not sure. I am fairly new to standard. I knew quite a lot of standard thanks to Angelo and people like him who do podcasts about standard. Well, I can't use it, right? Because if I just detention swear him, he faces out the Aetherling, and it doesn't do anything. So I'm just helpless here and under a two-turn clock. Here he comes back. I wonder if the Aetherling was in his sideboard against control, because it sure seems like a great card against control. The ability to do 8 damage a turn is pretty strong. And his exile ability is very strong as well. So he will finish late games. And not even Obsedat. Maybe I should sell my Obsedat. It looks like he looks really weak compared to the Adeling. Doesn't he? Maybe he's a lot better against aggro. And that's it. Thank you for watching Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan and I was playing Esper Control in Standard against Ravver Control. White, blue, red. And I got my ass kicked hard.